discussed customers, competency we are aware, you know, we need, obviously if we're going to run a hotel, I think one of us should at least know how to chop some onions and, you know, slice some potatoes, okay? Some competency is needed. Is it good enough? Sometimes a lot of students come to me and say, sir, you know, we are project team together. And how did you come as a team together, sir? By roll numbers, okay? And because of which we come with this project, and now that we have done this project, we think it's a great product that, you know, I can take to the market, and please help us, you know. My job as chief mentor is to obviously mentor everyone who comes and says, I have an idea. So what do? Can teams be formed with roll numbers? Teams formed? If no, then you obviously, my next question is how? If, see, that is the easiest way, you know, roll number 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, we make groups, no, in our class and say, how do we do that? All even numbers one side, odd numbers another side, make a group. Yesterday, we don't know, we made groups out of you. The only thing that we had in mind is we should not have two faculties from the same institute, in the same team, obvious reasons. So we said, okay, let's make team. But did we really understand whether you have the competency when we sent you out on the field? Did we really take the pain to, you know, understand, oh, you know, is Sanjeev and Venu, what kind of skills do they have, you know, and Usha, will she fit into the team? Did we do that? We should have, no? If we sent you out and said, okay, come back with a multi-million dollar idea, shouldn't we have taken the effort to understand the teams? We should have, right? We couldn't, because this is a classroom simulation. Here I am trying to make a point. Is there a skill? Is there some blood test that, you know, six people's blood test will find out, and, you know, if all these blood groups are there, then it's a good team? Or can we see six people's horoscope and decide whether they are going to be successful? So can we match six people's horoscope and decide whether this team is good? Then what? My question is, if no, then what is the yes?
Everyone should possess different abilities.
Different abilities, okay. Ashutosh. Come on. Simple question. How do we form groups? Look at ourselves, you know. We want to go out on a hike. Has anybody here is a active hiker? No, who goes out on hikes and treks and all? Area of interest, of course, area of interest is there because that is how they have come together. So that reason is there. But how do you form that group? My question. There is no definitive answer. If there was a definitive answer, I would be a multi-billionaire, because then I would patent that whole algorithm and, you know, give it on license basis to everyone. Download this algorithm, use it and form the best teams, and you will be then. There is no definitive answer. So I am asking you, maybe you know. I don't have an answer. So I can only tell you what I have experienced. Different nature. Yeah, I think all we agree that there has to be some amount of diversity. I think that is what we have all realized, that same thinking people is not something, you know, connectedness, yes, fair enough. But I think there's a general consensus. I can see that everybody is saying that, you know, we need different people here. Like in a bouquet, really looks good if you have different color flowers and, you know, some phool patta here and there. It looks very beautiful. No? Just one pink roses might look good, but others, you really need to make a bouquet. I think you need different color flowers. So I think we agree that there has to be diversity. So let me write down diversity. Second, what? These are all characteristics of good human beings. Future son-in-laws, future daughter-in-laws, you know, good students. They are all good characteristics. He should be honest, integrity, technically skilled, good communication skills. We are not talking of individuals. We are talking of teams. First thing, we have all agreed that it has to be diverse. That means you can't have people with the same skills. Okay, hunt together, somebody should have leadership skill. Yeah, it's all needed. What's the other? Only two basic things, two basic things I want to drive home. Because we are not experts, we are not psychologists or psychoanalysts to talk about. Yes, Sanjeev.
They should be ready to flow in one direction to achieve their mission of organization.
Okay, they should all be motivated, they should go all one. What is others, other most important characteristic of a good team. One is diverse. Second is, okay, I'll give you a hint. Who's this lady? Sunita Williams, right? She's gone to space all over again, okay? Now she's gone to space. What do you think her role would be there when she's there? She's going to be there for the next 6 months. She's some scientist, no? I'm sure that 50% of the time at least she'll end up doing some, you know, science of her things. Analysis, whatever she is, some meteors or something. What is the other 50% she'll be doing? She'll handle something else, yes. What else? When we send astronauts to the moon, no? Because since it is a limited number of seats, you can't have one guy who will cook food, one guy who will clean the aircraft from the inside, you know, one guy who will go out and, you know, to Mars and bring some vegetables. You can't have one guy who will drive the aircraft, one guy only to do experiments, one guy to do programming. Can we afford that? We will need people with multiple skill sets. One is diversity of team. Second is multiple skill sets. Okay, focus. These are, I'm saying that we have figured out these two as must-haves. When I'm saying diverse, I'm saying diverse backgrounds. Why do we need diverse backgrounds? Diverse does not mean that one from mechanical, one from civil, one from this.
Because it brings perspective. From different angles, you view a same problem. So that enriches your solution generating capability as well.
Okay, good. Diverse people, obviously, no? I mean, the whole Darwin's theory is based on that form that life has evolved because it is diverse, and you know, life has a very fundamental mechanism of choosing what is best. You know, if you put two things, good, bad here, life will choose the two goods from here and make something very extraordinarily better. So that is what evolution is all about. It's an evolutionary theory. So obviously we need people with multiple skills so that we can take all the goods, you know, and some of the negatives will get cancelled out. Okay, like if I'm very rude, okay, but I'm good in some job, I need to be counterbalanced by a guy who's maybe diplomatic enough to talk to people, okay, but maybe not so good in C programming. Yeah, diverse according to me generally mean they should have diverse socio-economic background. I'll tell you why. Because to take back and to a basic you know, framework, we look at three things, you know, for a good team. One is something called as risk propensity. Past demonstrated record. And connectedness. Don't get confused. I'm not trying to confuse you on this. But three core things are needed. What is risk propensity means? Some movie was released. There are some people who will rush and see that movie on that first day, first show, whatever. Come what may. There are some people who will say, boss, I want to see that movie, but let 10 people see it. Let me read in the newspaper. Let friends and colleagues recall me and let me know. And if I only know it is a good movie, then I will go. Both of them are spending the same amount of money for the tickets. It's not that the person who's seen later is spending less. So she wants to spend less. Our idea of rushing into something or taking that challenge varies. It's a graded thing. Okay, we have different types of risk. You know, you give business needs three people to invest 10,000, 10,000, 10,000 rupees each. Okay, one father says 10,000, leke jao yaar, kya farak padta, you know, take it in. Other guy's father says, boss, 10,000 you take back, I don't want interest, but at least you should, if the business does not work, you should give me back 10,000. And the third guy's father says, boss, what 10,000? Why should I give you 10,000? रिस्क प्रोपेंसिटी चेंजेस, ओके, अमाउंट रिमेन्स द सेम। बिजनेस के लिए कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, बिजनेस वांटेड 30,000 रुपीज, बिजनेस गॉट 30,000 रुपीज, बट थ्री पीपल्स परसेप्शन ऑफ द रिस्क इन्वॉल्व इन पुटिंग द 10,000 चेंज। जनरली यू शुड हैव पीपल विथ, ये तो ऑल फाइव पीपल आर अफ्रेड टू पुट मनी, दे आर वेरी गुड एट पुटिंग एफर्ट्स, अफ्रेड टू पुट मनी नॉट हैपन। सो टू दैट एक्सटेंट आई लुक एट जनरली सोशियो इकोनॉमिक बैकग्राउंड्स आर डिफरेंट, एवरीबडी कम्स विद डिफरेंट, एंड टुडे इन अवर क्लासरूम्स वी हैव अ ग्रेट अमाउंट ऑफ सोशल डाइवर्सिटी इन द क्लास। आई हैव सीन दो दे ऑल वेयर द ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ ड्रेसेस, बट आई थिंक देर इज अ ग्रेटर सोशल डाइवर्सिटी इन अवर क्लासरूम्स टूडे देन वॉट इट वॉज इवन 10 ईयर्स 15 ईयर्स बैक। सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज समबडी कम्स एंड टेल मी सर आई एम ग्रेट इन टू दिस एंड सॉलिड विल नॉट इम्प्रेस मी एट ऑल अनलेस आई हैव अ पास्ट डेमॉन्स्ट्रेटेड रिकॉर्ड। सर आई हैव दिस ग्रेट बॉय इज डन सॉलिड प्रोग्रामिंग इन सी एंड आई थिंक ही विल बी एबल टू डू, हाउ कैन आई बिलीव यू? सर लास्ट ईयर देर वॉज अ गूगल का ग्लोबल कॉम्पिटिशन एंड ही वॉज द गाय हु क्रैक्ड द कोड एंड ही गॉट एन अवॉर्ड, दैट इज पास्ट रिकॉर्ड फॉर मी। समथिंग स्पीक्स in your resume or something speaks in your profile that gives me that confidence that this guy is good. Sir, he is going to look at finance. Are you finance? What does he know? What does a 19-year-old boy in an engineering college know about finance? Is it right to expect? No. But sir, last year we had this annual day function and there was some 2 lakh rupees of sponsorship that had to be raised and this guy managed it. Gives me some confidence that कुछ दम है, यू नो, बिकॉज वी डोंट हैव इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ एनी एप्पल टू एप्पल कंपैरिजन फीचर्स आई कैन ओनली रिलाय ऑन पास्ट रिकॉर्ड टू डू दैट, ओके। एंड लास्ट इज व्हाट आई लुक एट, दो नॉट रियली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इज कनेक्टेडनेस। सो आई विल लुक एट सम काइंड ऑफ कनेक्टेडनेस। डू यू हैव सम कनेक्टेडनेस इन दिस बिजनेस? यस, देयर इज अ प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम स्टैनफोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी, where is his book? Okay. No. Yeah. Ed Roberts. Okay. He found out and he says, likelihood of technology driven startups succeeding increases dramatically if there are 3 or 4 founders rather than one. He did a study. Okay. He said that dramatically increases. He doesn't say just marginally increases. So if you're a technology startup, the chances of you succeeding will dramatically increase if you have 2 or 3 co-founders. Apple, how many co-founders? Names? Steve Jobs. Tim Wozniak, both Steves. Microsoft, how many? Microsoft. Actually 6, 7, but at least 2 very famous, right? Who are there? Paul Allen and there are 7 or 8 if you really look at it, but Paul Allen and our own company Infosys, 7 of them, okay, actually 8 if you discount one guy called Mr. Ahuja who left in 1990, the other 7 have all continued together, okay, 7, okay. So my personal experience, 2 is good, maybe 3 is also good, maybe more than 2-3 becomes an issue at a later date, okay, when especially if you can't handle interpersonal skills. But as students, I would generally be very unhappy looking at some one guy, you know, one man army coming and telling me, sir, I am good at everything. See, what is the age of your students when they come to you with these ideas? 1920. Just take yourself back all those years. What were you at 1920? So let's not put too much pressure on them, but let's at least make sure that if there are 2 or 3 guys, diverse backgrounds, we'll come down to why diverse backgrounds, multiplicity of skills, somebody is good in something, somebody is good in, chances of it does to succeed, nobody says of succeed, of surviving is much better. This all goes back to a theory by, heard of guy called Carl Jung, okay, he did some work on what, personality types, but more so personality types or creative problem solving. He said, okay, now what are the types of people in this world, let's, you know, classify them as part. So he said there are two types of people. What are the two types of people? Extrovert, introvert. How do we do know extrovert, introvert? Now, what is extroverted?
Outgoing.
Introverted? Keeping to yourself. Okay. Am I an extroverted person, introverted person? How can you say that? Because I keep on talking. Have you seen me talking to anyone when I sit alone? I don't even talk to Vasanti. Very difficult, okay? But theory is there that there are some people who better connecting outside. There are some people who are better looking deeper inside. We should have both. No, we said no, we want diverse background. So maybe we should have extroverted. Then he said both extroverted and introverted people can be further classified as four types of people. Sensing, intuition, thinking, feeling. English is a very funny language. Huh? Most of the words will sound almost similar. You say, what are you meaning? Sensing and intuition, feeling, thinking. They all sound the same. Does it sound the same? Carl Jung doesn't think so. Carl Jung says, two types of people, extroverted, introverted. Extroverted people also four categories. Introverted people also four categories. What are the four categories? Sensing, intuition, thinking, and feeling. Sensing. Let's come down to sensing. What does sensing mean? I can sense danger. Nonsense. Don't talk to me. This is nonsense. What does sense mean? We always use this word sense, but we really don't know. I also thinking what sense means. I come into the class and can sense that something is not good. Yeah, but based on what? How many sensory organs we have? You know, five sensory organs, no? Eye, sound, you know, tongue, all five sensory organs. Something that I can feel. I come into the class, I see the sitting arrangement change. My eyesight tells me that something is wrong. I come into the class, something is not smelling right. I know there is a dead mouse in the corner. Okay? So my senses tell me there are people who are very good at understanding their senses. You know, we've seen, no? People who don't have eyesight are maybe good at playing a musical instrument. You know, so nature has a way of compensating for these senses. So there will be people who are good with senses. What is intuition? Sixth Sense, okay, good movie. What else? Predetermined, something I know. You know, what is intuition? How many times we have betted on our intuition and said, I intuitively felt this is that. What is intuition? Where does it come from? This is a very important question. So people say, where did it come from? Yeah, what it means, I know something, but I can't really put a finger and tell you where it did I get this. But I had a feeling that this will go wrong. I had a feeling that this will definitely happen. There is an intuition feeling, okay? It is something that you can't explain. You can't put a finger. There is no formula. There is no mechanism. What? People say, initially, it is past karmas. You know, subconscious. Something that has been programmed into you, not only when you are, you know, when you are in the conscious mind, we use all the five senses, no? But when you sleep, what happens? Subconscious. All our five senses are down. Okay, but something still happens in our mind. Something, some programming happens. Subconscious. Some people say past life. You know, there are various theories. We don't want to get into that. But intuition does not come from any of the sensory organs. It comes from gut feel. Gut feel is an outcome. I am saying that where does it come from? It comes from past things, conditioning of your subconscious. Conditioning. There's some conditioning has happened. Okay. Maybe, you know, one of the reasons why the human being survived, they had this instinct as they grew up in the jungles that, and you know, as night falls, an animal will attack. That is why we have this instinctive feeling that when we see anything in the dark, we tend to run. Even in your sleep, in your dream, have you had this dream that you have fallen down and your heart starts beating fast? Now, actually, did you actually fall? But then why did your heart's beat go up? Because something that was programmed in your subconscious, your physical body is only reacting to that subconsciousness. That is an intuition feeling. It comes, you will find out that within people, there are people who rely a lot on intuition. Okay, they are not able to explain it to you why they think, but they have. What is thinking? Thinking is very simple. Thinking is brain, you know, simple knowledge, data, algorithm, formula, put together, answer aagya, left hand side equal to right hand side. Thinking, I know how this works. I can explain it to you, I can give you theory behind this, I can give you a logic for this. This is my thinking type. What is feeling?
Emotional.
Heart. Emotional. It comes from the heart. It has no explanation why happened love. It's like if I were to assign an organ, I would say, you know, sensing comes from the five sensory organs, intuition comes from my past life, thinking comes from my brain, and feeling comes from my heart. This is not important. What is important is the four parts that I have classified it. I have just said pre and post. What is pre and post? Before and after, now and then. What else? What does it mean? Pre and post. Why am I saying pre and post? There are typically two phases in your startup journey. One is when you are still struggling with prototype, idea validation, hoga ki nahi, you know, kaise banegi, how much will it cost. You are actually prototype. Pre is the product before the product is launched. Post is now everything is ready. I need to figure out, boss, abhi isko market kaise kare. Yeah, will this work, will this not work. So you have transcended that product part and you are saying that now I am ready here. So this is post, this is pre. We may have two types of students in our class. Somebody who is struggling here, somebody who is. I have put four blocks. What does these four blocks mean? Simple hai na, upar ka dekho na, mathematics lagao na. We need four types of people for free. We need four types of people for ideal. Yeah, this does not mean this is a rule. Please don't disqualify someone. This is a very, very ideal scenario. Okay, let's start by this block. Extroverted, you know, understand about extroverted? Intuition. Extroverted, he's a very outspoken guy, outspoken girl. Okay, relies heavily on intuition. She is a Or you can say a basic characteristic of an anthropo. Somebody who has that first kida in that mouth. Right. Yesterday when they went, four or five of them, everybody was seeing the crowd waiting at the bus stop. But the first guy who said, "Arey, people are waiting, maybe there's a problem." You know, he's relying on intuition. He's an extroverted. He's able to very clearly communicate. So maybe here is the leader of that team. Okay, I'm just trying to draw an analogy over here. What will this guy do? He's an extroverted guy, relies on senses. That means for him, sight is important, visual is important, this and that. What will he do? Professor Amarnath asked you to do an exercise yesterday. He will quickly get into making a prototype. He's a prototyper. You can describe, like, you know, they say picture speaks 1,000 words. You heard the phrase, no? A picture is worth 1,000 words. You tell somebody, very good idea, but I don't want to listen to you. Draw it to me and give it to me. Use it with your children. They want to come back and describe, you know, what happened in their school. You tell them that, forget it. Why don't you draw what happened in your class today? And look at the amount of detailing your child will actually put on that drawing, because now she is wanting to show everything that has happened in her class. It's not great art, but at the end of the day, the child is learning to think visually. It's a very powerful tool. Try it in your classroom with your students. This type of a person is also needed here. You of course need an entrepreneur. You of course need a somebody who will do a prototype. Then we move to an introverted type. Why do we need an introverted guy but who relies on senses? What does senses guy do? I told you. Data. He looks at all senses, you know, does it look good? Is there data available? You know, can I validate that? He is more of an investigator. आईपी सर्च है ना, कल बोला था वो, ये बंदे को बोलो करने को. ही विल गो, ही विल गिव ऑल कीवर्ड सर्च डॉक्यूमेंट, पुल आउट ऑल डेटा. ओके, दिस इज द गाय. ये गाय ने क्या बनाया? प्रोटोटाइप बनाया, क्विकली पेपर का मॉडल बनाया, यू नो, लेगो में से डिजाइन किया. अच्छा, दिस प्रोडक्ट विल लुक लाइक दिस, यू नो, प्रोटोटाइप गुड. दिस गाय केम अप विद दैट आइडिया. दिस गाय केम अप विद एन सर्च. अच्छा, दिस आइडिया लुक्स गुड. आई हैव ऑल्सो डन एन आईपी सर्च एंड नोबडी इज देयर इन दिस स्पेस. गुड इन्वेस्टिगेशन. ही हैज यूज्ड हिज इंट्रोवर्टेड सेंसिंग स्किल्स. इंट्रोवर्टेड इंट्यूशन गाय, ही रिलाइज डज नॉट रिलाय ऑन एनीथिंग एल्स. Somebody has to write their business plan, no? Chota sa. Ki kahan se aaya data, how was the prototype made, what analysis we used, what algorithm we used. Generally, entrepreneurs are bad with paperwork, let me tell you. Very bad. You ask them to write a one-page note. One of my first techniques to really see if somebody is genuinely interested in the business or see, one of my jobs is what is called as a phone and entrepreneur. In any and you go and say, I have this great business idea. First thing they will say is, please talk to Raj. This is his email ID. So if I'm a mentor, I have to tell them, very good, very nice idea. But right now I'm in the middle of something. Why don't you do one thing? Why don't you send me a 2-page note on what your idea is? I have yet to come across an entrepreneur who will send me an actual 2-page note. Either he'll send me a 50-page business plan, which has already some got it done, or he'll send me a half paragraph email. Entrepreneurs are bad. I've been an entrepreneur myself. I know paperwork is something that doesn't just go with this kind. You feel this is good enough to get your prototype off the ground? Good enough? ठीक है ना. आई हैव समबडी आइडिया. कोई तो एक छोटा सा उसका प्रोटोटाइप बना देगा, फटाफट इन्वेस्टिगेट करेगा क्या एल्गोरिथम लगता है, ये सब क्या डेटा, किधर किधर मार्केट शेयर किधर मिलेगा, क्या है. समबडी विल डू द स्ट्रेटजी, ले इट आउट ऑन अ प्रॉपर फॉर्मेट, रियल. ओके, लेट्स कम डाउन टू पोस्ट. वी नीड पीपल, नो, डिफरेंट टाइप्स. सी, अनफॉर्चुनेटली वॉट, वी कांट हैव दीज गाइज come here, right? We ideally need these different types of people, but as small companies, can we afford these types of people? No. So, thoda ye Carl Jung aadmi hai na, he was 150 years back. He did not realize that the world is getting fragmented. Here a person can have multiple. Now we have schizophrenia. No, what is schizophrenia? I think I am what I am, and I also think I am somebody else. So maybe, you know, maybe we need to find out, figure people with multiple skill set. Don't take it seriously. Psychology is a very great subject. I love it. I'm just trying to see what I can learn from psychology and apply it to simple business sense. That is my whole objective. Okay? So this, let me quickly go run you through this and you can figure it out. Typically, a guy who does customer management, customer relationship management, somebody who looks after your production systems, make sure that all the products are shipped out on time, somebody who keeps control on all the things, you may want to call him a CEO, COO. CEO and innovator could be different. Huh? You know Google CEO, who was it till some time back? Who was the Google CEO? a guy called Eric Schmidt. Okay, Eric Schmidt is 55 years of age. Larry Page and Sergey Brin are 28, 29 years of age. These are almost father's age, but they hired him as a CEO. Okay, now he has been, of course, shifted out. Okay, but for a long period of time for Google to succeed, innovator entrepreneur is different, reviewer CEO different. Okay, possible. Steve Ballmer, much better CEO. Okay, very rarely you get somebody who has a combined skills of, innovator plus reviewer plus, everything. Don't try to hope for that. Try and understand that we need people with diverse backgrounds. I would typically call this as sales, CRM, this as manufacturing, this probably as, COO, this more as finance. This is not critic, but critic, CRITQUE, who looks at things very rationally based on data. He does not go by the sales guy saying, "Sir, अगले मंथ में 10,000 पीसेस अपना बिकने वाला है." ओके, ही गोज प्योरली बाय, ही इज एन इंट्रोवर्टेड गाय, फीलिंग. Why was this template discussed? Not that you have to take this template and sit in your classroom and do it. It's a basic fundamental understanding of human types, human nature, and we can see whether our teams are in the class, whether they follow. Don't use this. This is not God's grid of that has been, given for entrepreneurships. Okay, this is just to understand that human beings can come in different packages. We need to be very clear that we need to have diverse people. We need to have multiple skills. We want to do a quick role play. Okay, my question when we fundamentally design this game is, the entrepreneur is at the age of 21, 22. He has maybe a advisor in the form of a faculty in his classroom or something like that, but he doesn't have really a father figure who can, really get down with him and understand, and design. Most of the guys look his age. Okay, how will he choose who is good for what job? How can we choose? He's a prototyper. There is a technique, there is an advanced technique called as MBTI. Please don't go in that direction. There's a technique. You can hire a consultant. Consultant will send you a nice bill. He will come and administer one questionnaire, and then questionnaire will actually give you the type of personality that you are, okay, in the organization. But I'm saying that is a fairly complex and expensive route. If I am a 10 people company, more or less all are my age, they wear all the same jeans, they listen to the same music, how the hell do I know who's good at what? So what's the best way to find out? Ask them questions. Everything, everything. I am done, done, done. Everything good. Actually, this is more likely a case, right? 9 out of 10 will say, "Arey, I am intuitive thinker also, and I am also extroverted feeler. Don't worry, I can do prototype. I can also do strategy. Don't worry." And we'll all be happy. And we'll all be confused. Best. Have you heard of a word called as crowdsourcing of wisdom? Somebody yesterday used the word co-creation. I don't know who. Where did I heard? Okay, co-creation is now a new theory in management, where we say that we are not smart enough to design the next level of product. So let us ask our customers what they want, and then we crowdsource the wisdom. Okay, and then we say, okay, crowdsourcing of this wisdom is good. So we now know what the customers. My funda is ask everyone what you think you should be doing, and what you think the other guy should not be doing. Okay, this is an honest opinion. I am good at this, but I think that guy is not for that, which is okay, which is an honest opinion, honestly. Like, I am good at marketing, but I don't think this guy should be in finance. I think this guy is good in finance, but I definitely think that other guy should not be in finance. So you crowdsource within your company. It's a good exercise, a very good exercise. It is like asking everyone, what do you think? Who should look at the marketing? Who do you think should be in the finance? Who do you think? And you ask this to everyone. Okay, it's crowdsourcing. And then of course, you are the CEO, you are the owner of the company. You have to take a wise judgment on what is. Okay, chalo, out. We'll do this game and then we will, you know, quickly come out. Everyone out, step out.
So instead of passing the parcel, we will throw the balls at you. Okay, so to catch and then throw it randomly to anyone. Randomly, just randomly. As long as the music plays. Okay. The moment music stops, the person who's caught with the ball has to give the ball to the other team member, go out. There is actually a sheet of paper which you have to fill. Okay? This sheet of paper actually tells very quietly. Don't write your name, don't sign. So your boss does not know what you have given as a feedback. What you have to do is this, it has very simple things. It says for these functions, who I think is a driver. Driving, you understand? Somebody who can drive this. Rapid prototyping. I think this guy can drive it well. There is a showstopper. Somebody who is not good. Giving stop. And then there are some guys, does not matter. There are three kinds of people. Somebody who is very good, somebody is not so good, and somebody doesn't mind if he is there out there. Okay? And every one of us will fill up this sheet. So what happens at the end of the round? The CEO gets, or the innovator gets, how many sheets?
5, 6, 7,
depending upon what his team members are. And then he has to sit. Now he has the views of the entire team. He knows exactly what everybody else is feeling about him. And then he can probably use that chart, some knowledge that he got from here, in defining how to make the team. Sound interesting?
Yeah.
Very good. Okay.
Connect with each other and own the idea? No. Right? So to this extent, this exercise does not make sense for us as a classroom activity. We just wanted to demonstrate to you how it can be done in your classroom. Okay? So don't think, I have to fill up this up right now and give it. Okay? It's not for you. This is typically for a team which has worked, you know, brainstormed, come with this idea, sir, prototype hum log ka ready hai. I really don't know now, you know, where to go. I have come into your classroom seeking some help on, you know, take this business. This is what our objective is, right? To take our students to the next level. That is for them. Why the ball? No significance. Why the music? Fun element. Okay, because we realize that without having fun, you know, 19-year guys don't even update their Facebook status. Okay, so you have to add the element of fun into everything. So this music, the ball, the concept of the game, was only to stimulate the fun activity. Why we said separately go out and fill? Because we don't want somebody to know what did he write about me. I am good at what? What does he know? Ki I am good at what? How can he say that I am not good at something? Here you are giving opinion on three kinds of people. Somebody who is really good at it, you think. Somebody who is definitely not good at it, you think. And somebody is chalta hai, hai nahi hai, doesn't matter. Okay? And you are taking everybody's opinion. Please understand, a small entrepreneurial organization is one of the most democratic institutions. Everybody has a right to say everything. We are still not reached a stage where the other people call the innovator as the boss or sir. Okay, it's a very democratic institution. You can visualize, right? They're all 22, 23, 24 years of age. They don't have a formal reporting structure. They don't have any. They're all sitting in one room, sitting on computer and doing some stuff. And you still need to form these teams. Are you with me? Exercise is not, again, like I said, is not God's 10 commandments, one of the exercises. This is just one of the ways you can figure out your own way of getting. The whole idea is we should have a good innovative team. Good innovative team comprising of people with diverse backgrounds, multiple skill sets. I found this to be a good exercise which I can teach in a class, do it in a classroom. Good? Okay, good.